Hello Aquarians, welcome to my channel Surabhi, and this is the reading for you for the last 10 days of May. And as you know, they are all general readings. They may or may not resonate with each and every one of you. They may be your energies, energies of the person or the situation you are dealing with, or maybe the mix of both. So please feel free to swap the characters according to your situation. If the reading does not resonate with you, please check your moon sign, Venus sign and the name sign. And if you want to get a personal reading, the details are given in the description box below. And for extra readings, you can follow me on Instagram. The link again is given in the description box below. And the readings on Instagram are done in Hindi as well as in English. Okay, so, and yeah, as these are general energies, you know, they are general readings. So please feel free to swap the characters according to your situation. Okay, so Aquarians, let's see what's in store for you. Wow. Would like to see some better messages for Aquarians. See what are the messages from the other deck for Aquarians. Okay, we have the strength, guidance from the angels, Aquarians. What I am feeling here is, though the reading is starting with a beautiful card, which is the World card, but things don't seem to be very good over here. So what I am feeling here is that you try to start something new in a different way, or a new mindset, or you thought of okay, I'll try it once more. It's something like that. That is what I feel with this, with these cards, that you tried something perhaps in a different way, or you thought of starting something new. Okay, because it was something ended and something began. It was a completion of a cycle, and when this new cycle started, whatever it was, you wanted to do it or it happened, I really don't know. because it is not looking very good for you basically. So it can be that you try to do something new or try to do something different, or you thought, okay, I'll try one more time, it's something like that. But then when you tried one more time, it was not fruitful, it didn't turn out to be good, and it led you to a lot of tension. Because here, when you tried this new, or whatever this new was for you in whatever situation you are dealing with, so it is definitely, it was something new, it had something new to it. It can be your new way of doing it, it can be your new approach of doing it, it can be with a new person, it can be trying to make amendments one more time with the situation or the person you're dealing with. It can be anything, but there was something new to it, but totally unrequited and totally it didn't just work out basically. That's what I'm trying to say, it didn't work out actually. Okay, and what you felt was that there was a lot of tension in it, you felt ignored. Perhaps when you tried to make, see, it can be a reconciliation, maybe you tried to reconcile with the person and they didn't take it. Okay, because here you are being ignored, you are being rejected, left out in the cold. Maybe it didn't work out, or maybe they didn't want to reconcile, or they didn't want a new start. It can be that also. Okay, so it, whatever new it was for you, it didn't work out. And this is how you are feeling rejected, you are feeling ignored, you are feeling shattered. And with the Five of Swords, there is some dispute and argument, and things are falling apart. Things are falling apart. So this new, whatever this new was, either it was not accepted by the other person, maybe the other person is not ready to accept this new beginning, or they don't want to reconcile, they don't want a new beginning with you once again, or they are not liking it. It has been rejected basically, whatever this approach was, and you are feeling very bad because of that. And this is what is happening, you are really really upset, you feel backstabbed, you feel as if why the hell did you do all that. And the thing now is that you've just left the situation totally, you have totally surrendered to the situation, you have totally left the situation, and you are just trying to heal yourself, because this is causing you a lot of anxiety, depression, sleepless nights, you're really not at all happy. Okay, really, it talks about a lot of you feel you are in a total wreck, total breakup of emotions, total wreck sort of, and you really need to heal out of it. It is a very very brutal type of an energy which you are feeling. You're maybe totally too much of depression. Okay, it's calling it's talking to me about a total depression and total surrender. You just give it up. Okay, it's like, now I won't do that again. It's something like that, and it's causing you a lot of anxiety. You are not able to sleep at all. Okay, and you are overanalyzing and overthinking as to, and what I feel here is that you are even feeling as to, why the hell did I try it? What came in my mind? Why should I have done it again? I knew it won't be solved, but why did I try to solve it? Okay, it's something like that which is coming to me. You are feeling even ashamed as to what was the need for me to do it when I knew that it won't work out? It's something like that. Okay, and then once you have totally surrendered, what I feel here is, once you have totally surrendered, what I feel here is that then you are, once you heal yourself and you totally surrender to the situation, here you are ready to just leave it to destiny. Just, okay, now I'll live my own life, I'll do whatever life brings to me, and you are ready for a new beginning basically, because you are now fed up over here, you just given it up, and you are ready for a new beginning. That's what I'm saying. I don't feel anything else is coming over here as for now, any opportunity or anything, no, but it is just an energy which comes after healing. Okay, now you are healed, you are done with it, you're over with it, ready for the new beginning, ready for the new chapter of your life, and here you want to start something totally in now difference between this chapter of your life and this chapter of your life is, here you are not doing anything yourself. Okay, you are not planning, you are not strategizing, you don't have anything in your mind, you don't have any ideas, you will walk as life takes you ahead. It's something like that. So you have totally surrendered, and this is the energy of the surrender. Okay, I have surrendered. Okay, now whatever happens will happen for good. I'll accept it. It's something like that. You yourself are not doing anything much in this situation. Okay, you've just left it. And you are ready to accept. It is the positive, very positive part here is that you are ready to accept what life gives you now. So whatever life gives you now, you are ready to accept it and you are happy with it. And what I feel here is that this tower is coming over here, which is causing you a total shake-up. So something unexpected comes over here as soon as you are able to surrender to the situation and you are ready for the new beginning. And this unexpected is coming as a cause of celebration. It is not coming as something bad. It is this some unexpected event is which is it leaves you shattered in the sense that you're not expecting it. That's it. But it is followed by the Three of Cups, which is celebration. So what I feel here is that this is as you surrender to the situation, as you are ready for a new beginning, leaving everything to God, leaving everything to destiny, unexpected celebrations come in. And here you are healing with the Nine of Pentacles. You are healing, you are giving time to yourself, and you are able to replenish your energies. And here with the Nine of Cups, you are emotionally fulfilled, content and happy. Okay. And here with the Page of Cups, the Six of Cups, a new, you are ready, you have replenished your energies, you rejuvenated, given time to yourself, and it happens immediately after you surrender yourself to the destiny or the plans what God has for you. Okay, and here you have the Page of Cups, so definitely you are ready to offer your emotions to someone. And here it is again followed by the Six of Cups, which is reconciliation. So what I feel here is it is not reconciliation with the same person. What I am feeling here is it is returning of the happy times, once when you were happy. Okay, I think once you do this, it is returning of the happier times. Okay, so you are either feeling nostalgic of the happy times once you had in your life, or you are trying to create those happy times by offering this love or opportunity, whatever it is, to somebody, and you want happiness in your life, like once you were in a relationship, when you were happy in a relationship, it's something like that. So because you are basically trying to recreate that happiness in your life, and you are offering your emotions or love to somebody. And here that with the Judgment and with the Three of Wands, what I feel here is this is something which you were trying to do since a long, long time. You were trying to recreate your happiness. You were trying to have a happy relationship since a long, long time. And you were waiting for the right time, perhaps. Or you're trying to have a clearer picture and try to think over the things which were causing your heartbreak and which were causing you to struggle. Okay. So it is something which was a judgment which was because of the fact on the situation which was causing you a lot of heartbreak and a lot of tension and a painful condition, and you were struggling in that. So this is the decision which has been made on this situation, and once you are able to take this decision that you are recreating happy memories or happiness for your life, things will fall in line. But one thing which I'm getting again and again over here is just beware of being falling into a love triangle. There may be a love triangle in this situation for some of you. Okay, so because I'm getting threes in this situation, so just beware of this thing that check it out, that there is no love triangle in this situation, because again it will lead to a heartbreak if it is that. Okay, so Aquarius, the moment you let go of this, surrender to the divine, let go of this negativity, you will be able to find happiness. Let me see what is the guardian angels, what the guardian angels have to say. Ace of Emotion. This cherub is announcing that a wonderful new emotional experience is coming into your life. You may meet someone new who makes your heart flutter, or a current relationship with experience a reawakening. It is also possible that your intuitive abilities will be greatly increased by your open heart. So now what I feel here is, though I did say that this comes as a sudden event, unexpected event, and it is followed by a celebration. So I didn't feel that it is coming from the old relationship. But since here we have the reconciliation card also, and here this one is also talking about that there may be a reawakening of a current relationship. So maybe for some of you it can be that also, that once you stop investing in it, once you stop working on in that relationship and you just leave it, you surrender to the divine, and that is a shake-up or a realization for the other person, and then they come in to reconcile, and that is the cause of celebrations. Okay, so it can be that also for some of you, because here also there is some sort of reconciliation or recreation of happy memories. So if for some of you it can be a reconciliation, for some of you it can be a new relationship. That is what is coming through from that card. But again, you have to be wise of a love triangle here. Number 48 may be of some significance for you. Demonstrate love. Find out what is important to those you love and act on it. So this is the universal guidance from the universe that you have to demonstrate love in the situation, whatever the situation is, and you need to be kind to yourself, love yourself, and the once you are in a loving position, the horizons expand for you basically. Okay, there are a lot of horizons which expand for you. There are people who come in touch with you and they also offer you that love once you are in a positive state of mind. So what I feel is once you do that there will be a total blossoming of your life. So you need to be in a happy place, and you need to be in a loving place, at least for your own mental state, for yourself and for this relationship. Be it the old one, be it the new one, whatever it is, it will be different for different people, but yes. And here, with the Queen of Clubs over here, it is requiring a lot of strength, a lot of confidence, a lot of strength is needed to deal with this situation, whatever this situation is. Okay, yes, and you have the strength to deal with it, okay, and you are dealing with it. So it is the judgment time, it is the judgment time. Things are being sorted out, that's what I feel. The moment you surrender, things will fall in line. Okay, Aquarian, so that's all I have for you. Hope it helps, and please subscribe to my channel if you like what I do. Thank you.